Welcome to a brand new series of Gems of Goa with me, Alicia Fernandez. Yes, this is the season two of Gems of Goa. And today, to begin with this particular season, we have with us the ever-smiling, beautiful, the charming, and the most amazing person that Goa has produced and Goa has always been proud of. We have with us Mrs. Hema Sardesai. Hello, ma'am, to Prime TV. Finally!
Hi, sweetheart. Hi, Alicia. We could do this. I'm so glad. And you're such a pretty girl. You're such a lovely girl. And what a lovely introduction to me. Thank you so much. A little kiss to you and a big hug. Yeah? Thank you.
Yeah. Yes. Thank you so much, ma'am. But right now, to begin with, if I may get into this particular interview, I want to ask you one question, which I think several people want to know about you, because there's a lot of things written and said about you, but we want to hear it from you. And the most important of it all is, how did you get into this music industry and how did music happen to you? Was it like a general thing that just like went with the flow, or you planned for it and it happened? Please go ahead.
Okay, so what happened was, since childhood, I've been, singing and my teacher in school, she heard me singing this song, Sing Your Way Home, and she called my father. She's late Mrs. Sequeira, that beautiful lady.
Mm-hmm.
And she told him, this girl is going to become somebody someday. Okay, wow. And it went on like that. After that, everybody who heard me, would tell my dad and mom that she is going to become a great singer. But, the divine is us. And, after all the first prizes in our beautiful, beautiful Goa, I'm chain Sundar Sundar Goa, and the Mogar look, all the love that I got from them, I suddenly win the Grand Prix in Germany while I'm still studying, And competing mm-hmm. with 21 countries, representing my country, audience darling there. And my name is all on the papers in the front pages. See, big divine hand there, yeah? So always that thing was there that I have to work for society. I have to do something for society. I have to, I have to worry about truth and justice. I have to do my duty and responsibility mm-hmm. to my state and my country. And that was something I always did. I was the first person, even getting into Bollywood was so tough despite winning the Grand Prix, because it's a place where, mm-hmm. Wherever there is fame, power and money, there are compromises people make for with their values, their principles, their virtues, sure. To gain fast everything, Yes, yeah, that is priceless. And, being a singer and being achieving is what the divine gives you. And what you can do in return is be respectful, grateful, loving, and giving, And I've tried in my best way to be that. I don't know if I've done the best, but I've tried to be to do that. Yes.
You have indeed. You have indeed, to be frank with regard to that. Many people are looking at you as a role model. Indeed.
Thank you, my sweetheart. Thank you. It's also, such a doll.
Yes. Also, if I may ask you now, like you said just now, that it was very difficult for you to get into Bollywood. You didn't have any godfathers, as it is put in that way. So how exactly did you do the first thing? I think it was in 1996, I think. Tere Mere Sapne, I think. It was the one that's how did
Seven.
That happen to you?
Yeah, before that, 97? Yes. After the Grand Prix, this beautiful person who was who's from Goa, Joy Augustine, he was the producer of Goonjville, mm-hmm. yeah? And he's a very decent guy. Joy Augustine has made it big in the industry as a great producer and director of films. And he said, Hema, you have to sing my song. And I'm very grateful for that, because working with decent people is a rare thing, is a treasure thing, yeah. So I got to sing that song Sama Ye Suhana in Gunj Pop Juhi Chawla. That was her first film, and mm-hmm. then the struggle started, which was so funny. I mean, I'm with the Grand Prix, I sing for a film which is a song loved by everybody, and then I'm struggling because I'm walking out of studios because people are telling me, everybody does this compromising of values and principles. Why can't you do it? And I would say, no, I will never tamper with the gift that God has given me. I will always treasure it. And it's something I'm committed to for my parents, who look up at me as their child. I will not let them down, neither my goals down, you know, who expect the best from me. And I will not sell myself for anything in the world. You know, despite that, when you have that faith in the divine and the blessings of your own parents and your people and your blessings of your sister and, you know, every friend of yours who loves you and, you know, so many blessings, then the divine obviously supports you for treasuring what has been given. And I did more than 100 songs, Alisha.
Exactly. In that too, I think almost 25 years now. It's almost, I think December 21,
it's going to be 20 years. 1997, Avara Bhavre happened because in the middle it was just the struggle, right?
Okay.
So, 22 years.
It's indeed commendable.
Yeah.
2 decades already.
Yeah.
Also, if I may ask you, like when you put this first at home that you wanted to get into Bollywood, and what was the reaction from family when it came at this particular point of time when you said, like, you know, I'm somebody new, I want to try on my own, I want to get over there, I want to make sure that, you know, I get into the industry. Obviously, people have the preconceived notions about certain industries, and film industry being one of them. So what was the reaction at home, back home?
actually, it was everybody's dream at home. It was not mine. I have been quite a happy... I was known as happy-go-lucky in school. You know, I used to even sometimes get in my studies, either I was very good or I was very bad. I used to also get in maths, I remember I got 0 out of 10. And I went to my teacher and said, Miss, I got 0 out of 10. And she was like Hema can be happy with anything, you know. So it was like that. Nothing got me sad, you know. So I was always a content child, but I could see it was my parents had so many compliments pouring in for me, seeing them and everything. They knew she can, you know, shine out there, and we need to encourage her. Although she's in her own world, we need to encourage her, you know. And they did all the way, my sister, my parents. They encouraged me. After that, when I got married, my husband, Xavier D'Souza, he also gave me a lot of encouragement, and you know, and so there are a lot of people behind always what you achieve. There's the divine who is leading you. It's nothing about you. It's about how much people have wanted you to be there, including my Goans, and the love they've given me since childhood. Whenever I sang, all this is attributed to everybody. You know, it's not your achievement. It's everybody's achievement.
Yeah. Indeed, which is totally commendable. What we're going to do right now is that we're going to slip into a short break. On the other side, we are going to talk to you more in terms of your social activist. You've been very vocal about a lot of issues. All about that on the other side of the break. So stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
This is Info Media Prime Slot Network. And you're watching Prime. Your voice, your channel.
Welcome back. We are in conversation with Hema Sardesai, and now to discuss more about your life, as we already discussed about your music life. Now, if I may ask you more in terms of how has been the other side of your life, where you have been always vocal about several issues, be it about Save Girl Child or for that matter, standing for what is right. So how exactly this thing happened? If you could just take us through that as well.
It's something that comes naturally to me, Alisha. Since I was a child, I remember my childhood friends, they're so adorable, and they adore me too in their own sweet, sweet, loving way. So they always say that you were a fighter for the truth and justice since you were a child. If a teacher was in trouble, I would stand by her. If a fellow friend or a classmate was in trouble, I would stand by her. It came very naturally to me, you know. So when I even entered the industry, I was very worried about the girl child, because I could see that in many houses, I come from a house, my dad being a doctor, my mother being a beautiful housewife, you know, and I have an elder sister and me, no brother. So we never felt like, we were never made to feel there is a lack of a brother in the family, you know, or a son in the family. But everywhere I would see that girls would be lesser nicely treated than the brother in the family, you know, her brother, my friends, So I would tell their parents, I would say, like, why are you doing this? I mean, she's so precious also, isn't she? I mean, why are you being nicer to the son, you know? And then I got to know from my little knowledge here and there that it's been happening in some places in India and the world where the girl children are actually, not brought into the world because she's a baby girl, then she's destroyed either in the stomach or even when she's born, so much of cruelty. So in my first album that happened, pop album, Hindustani Gudiya, in the second video where I got to direct the video also, it was, the song was Hindustani Gudiya, it's there on the net, and that I depicted the girl child, and I was the first one to voice it out as a person known in India. So I voiced it out that, you know, give respect to the girl child first. And then on my work for Women Empower, it just came naturally to me. So the media have given me a sweet title, Ambassador for the Girl Child. And coming from the media, it's so genuine, you know. Then fighting for Goa and, you know, for saving Goa. And I have my own way of saving Goa. I'm not like every other social activist. I have my own thoughts, my own, way I would like to save Goa. And I have been trying to save Goa. And I do my best because I feel, because mostly people do it. There are good activists. There are genuine activists. But some of them do it because they want to get into politics. They want to, you know, be appearing like a martyr in the limelight as a martyr. Somebody who's already, been gifted by God, like 100 and more songs in the industry, gone to Hollywood, you know, sung with 6 superstars, including Amitabh Bachchan and Shah Rukh Khan, and, you know, so many other albums and stuff like that. Doesn't need to do this because you're already loved, you know. You're already loved. But somebody who cares, you know, because the divine has given me this, so what can I do back for society? It comes naturally. It's not a favor, like I said, I'm doing to anybody. It's a natural thing to care, you know. So anytime, I will not ever step in myself. If somebody comes to me and says, Hema, we need your help, or we need you to come on this podium and help us, and if I can do it in my best capacity, I go ahead and do it, you know. That's the minimum we can do.
Definitely. But does it, you feel bad about the fact that when people, right now social media is up and there are a lot of memes which are being done, especially with regard to, you know, when you're doing it for a good cause, but people take it in like, you know, it's right now not the time, and people have their own notions, preconceived notions about certain things. So how are you dealing with that as well? There is a lot of...
I never knew
you stand up for something.
Yeah, you know, I never knew in life, Alisha, that there is something called hatred, you know. I've known Goans to the most loving people on earth, yeah. Mogar log samke. Samke mog amcha bidor mja amcha roktan hamniyata, and it's in our soil also, love, you know. And all most Goans are talented. But I realized that there is this small little group, you know, who's trying to separate everybody. One group here and one group there from opposite sides, tiny groups who use social media with fake IDs and stuff like that, you know, and both these groups sadly originate from Panjim. You know, they are opposite kind of groups, but they're trying to separate society, and they do it beautifully with many fake IDs on Facebook. I have worked towards stopping those fake IDs. I've worked towards stopping this hatred, which doesn't exist in Goa. Everybody from every religion love each other as Goans, you know. So for me, I've stopped, you know, giving so much importance to one criticism here or one criticism from some fake ID or something, when the bulk of the people know you are genuine, you know, that they know you're selfless and you are not asking for any political thing or any accolade or anything from anybody, from any government. She hasn't taken anything or asked for anything. Then they know that this girl cares about us in the right and the correct and the most humblest way. And then they appreciate it. How much can you lie to people?
Definitely.
You know, people who are lying are going to get caught at some point or the other. So you cannot lie about somebody all the time, right? So the truth is always seen who's genuine and who's sincere. And then that is that appreciation is what I call an achievement. Yeah.
Indeed, definitely. Also, there's a lot of trolling which happens also. So when the trolling happens, how do you deal with that and how do you face it? Because a lot of youngsters feel very demoralized. So they feel discouraged when such things happen. They do not know how to, they either deactivate the account or they think of other possible ways. But that's not the solution to all these, as you said just now.
But fortunately for me, Alisha, I haven't had trolling done on me. Not that I know of, really. Like I said, one or two sites of fake IDs, you know, which have already been exposed. So, you know, that doesn't matter. But genuine people, I mean, people with genuine IDs and stuff like that, trolling has never happened. I'm fortunate there and thankful and grateful. But at the same time, I would like to tell those who are doing good work and if they are getting trolled, please do not wait for impressions from humans. You know, do something where your conscience, which is connected to the divine, you know, do something where the divine is impressed. So you are happy. Don't wait for accolades from humans, you know. Don't wait for them to criticize you or judge you. Let the divine judge you, you know. And when you let the whole, you know, you everything to the divine, it's natural that humans also will see your genuineness.
Yeah, also, if I may ask you another thing before we slip into another short break of ours, is that you have digitized your music. So it's on the artist.com. How was that experience for you when you decided to do that?
Well, this is a nice advertisement for Artists Aloud. So sweet, Alisha. I must tell Somini, she'll be very happy. At a time, a sad thing happened to music, and that is downs. Free downloads. You know, a sad thing happened to music because when you have downloads, what happens is the new talents and the good talents that they don't make money and make a career because of the free downloads, you know, which is very, very sad. I'm working towards it to stop these all across the world, you know, some leader will have to take a stand on it to make sure that great music and real artists. Gen artists get their limelight in the right way and they make a career out of it also, which is not happening now. So for me, it was very essential that, you know, I give my things like Artists Aloud. They promote artists and they help rise also. So if people like me who are known support such sites, you know, like Artists Aloud, gives new artists also a boost to come in, yes, and get promoted. You know, it makes the site bigger, and you know, songs can be heard by the upcoming artists also who want to make themselves somebody and make some money out of it. You know, so that's why it was important to be on Artists Aloud, not only for your songs but to give a boost to new artists.
What we will do is right now we'll slip into another short break. On the other side, we still have Hima Sodasai and we will continue conversation with her and also our exciting segment which is called the Rapid Fire Round on the other side of this break. Stay tuned.
This is Info Media Prime Slot Network. And you're watching Prime. Your voice, your channel.
Welcome back in conversation with Hima Sardesai and she's going to speak with us also about her life and much more. Till now, as for what we have discussed is about music, social activism, what she has been doing. And also now, if I may ask you also one more thing before we slip into a rapid fire round. So before that, if I may ask you, what has been the difference or has there been any difference from Hima who had joined the industry back then to Hima now?
You should ask my friends and my family. They say, I'm fortunate that at least that's what they say, but do ask them. My husband says, you know, you're a Hemu. And my sister, my friends all say, you've always been a Hemu. You know, you can ask my childhood friends. They say, Hema to change hi nahi hui. Hema matu hi change laam na. Same, you know. You know, because it's not our achievement, no? Whatever we achieve, like I said, is given to us by the divine. So you have a duty. Every one of us has a duty to remain humble and thankful and grateful all the time. And how can we give back to society for all that I have been gifted? Yeah. So that's what the thing was. So that is, hey, Ma, still the happy-go-lucky, full of love. What can I do for you, girl?
Ashwin.
Yeah,
we just hope it continues to be that way. And also, if one more thing, what I may ask you is, in terms of anybody who wants to get into this industry, what are the things that they need to keep in mind, especially when they are from a non-music background, especially from nobody like you who have no godfathers in the industry?
Yes. Well, like I said, I've already told you my journey, keeping up the values and principles, never compromising my values, principles and virtues for anything, never selling my soul for, you know, fame and money. Because the real happiness in life is not money, fame and power. It's not. Don't think that's because somebody is famous or somebody has more money or somebody is more powerful, they're happier than you. No, happiness is something that even a poor person can feel, even a non-famous person can feel, and those are achievements. When you feel happy, that is an achievement. Being famous is not an achievement. Being powerful is not an achievement. Having a lot of money and wealth is not an achievement. Achievement is when from inside you're happy and you want to give to society, you want to do seva, you want to do service selflessly. That's what my Gurudev, His Holiness Sri Sri Ravi Shankar says. And since I feel connected to him for lifetimes, I'm sure since childhood, you know, he only has imbibed this in me. And so if nothing is what I have done. Everything is for me. He's the divine for me. And, you know, I see all gods as one. So for me, this is the achievement is to be happy, which is the most difficult thing for humans to do, to be happy. They don't know what is going to give them happiness. And if they are feeling happy, that is an achievement.
And that too from within. That is more important.
Absolutely. Not drama. You know.
Definitely. Yes, I think those are some really wonderful words of yours. So now what we're going to do is we're going to get into the exciting. So brace yourself as we begin the rapid fire round. Okay, what is the one thing that you would put on your bucket list?
How to be the genuine follower of the divine is my aim now.
Indeed. Okay, who is your favorite superhero and why?
My superhero is my Gurudev, His Holiness Sri Sri Ravi Shankar, and because in the eyes of the world, he's the greatest humanitarian on earth, so selfless, hasn't asked for anything for himself, and everybody should emulate. He's the superhero.
Indeed. Okay. What is your favorite hobby other than music?
Other than music, my God, it's not a hobby, but I adore animals and whatever I can do for them in the best way. Since childhood, it's been like that, Alicia. Even in my neighbor's house, if a dog was sick, if he had, you know, because they get these infections with maggots and all, I would sit down and clean and never feel clean, dirty. You know, so it's always been there. I also was made trustee of one of the dog animal shelters recently in Goa.
Wow.
In Panjim, okay. But I didn't like the way things were happening there, so I resigned. But when I was there, I gave my heart and soul, you know, because then people would say, like, you've forgotten your Hema Sardesai. I said, what is Hema Sardesai if she cannot be of help to these animals, you know? So it's like that. So people have a notion of fame, money and power in a different way. Unless you give to society and you are there for people and you're loving and giving, you are nothing, you know?
True. Indeed. Okay, what is it? One song which you can describe yourself?
Oh, myself. You know, come on, hold my hand. I want to contact the living. you know, I don't know, Robbie Williams, I think that was. Mm-hmm. I feel is the song. I don't know, I feel that was written for me. But yes, my song, Power of Love, if everybody would like to see it, just put Power of Love and Hema, of course, because there are many Power of Loves. That also says me, because it tells everybody, you know, be in strength, be positive, you know, for a winner. That's what I want. The whole youth of the world is there in that song, Power of Love. So everybody...
Then I could ask you one more question in terms of what would be the, if you had to check, which subject would you have?
I was allowed to take the subject. I did get the opportunity. It would be spirituality, for sure. But spiritual with the icing on the cake, love, and how to, tell everybody to belong to each other. Why there should not be border, there should not be religions, there should not be separatism of any kind, you know, everybody should be one. You know, COVID, when it came, it never said you're from religion or, you know, it just showed that everybody is just one. We are just human, you know, and to be human is to be very, very with each other, very respectfully loving and grateful and generous always. That is being a good human being. Not competing and being insecure and, you know, and stuff.
Amazing job in this maiden rapid fire round of season 2 of Gems of Gold. Thanks so much for taking them off. Before you leave, I would not let you go before you sing for us something of your choice. Go ahead.
Okay, for sure. With all my love for you and for all my Goans out there, dear Alisha, thank you for having me, and I'm going to sing this. Khub khub mogan ekdom itle sobe goamche meuche na dusre shakhiche sobitain te bollene ani soglyache te mogache dene amka te devache sodans wing marun rauche goan tora miya sadko
Wow, thank you so much. It was so amazing having you. Thank you so much for taking time off once again and being with us for the first episode of Gems of Goa. It was an honor having you once again. Thanks a lot. Thank you.
And may you be blessed always and lots of blessings and health, best health and happiness to all my Goans.
Praise God. Thank you. Thank you so much. Yes.